Welcome to my class. Unit 2, Algebra. This comes for 10 marks in our board exams. It consists of two topics. One is matrices and the second is determinant. Now let us first see the topic matrices. Now here you can see the syllabus of matrices. In the first lecture, we will see the definition and types of matrix. So in this syllabus, you can see we will cover up to this symmetric and skew symmetric matrix in this particular chapter. So let us begin. Matrix, how we define this matrix? It is a set of m into n numbers arranged in the form of rectangular array of m rows and n columns is called m into n matrix. How we read it? We read it as m by n matrix. So total number of elements which I have is m into n, and we arrange them in m rows and n columns. Let us see how we do that. So here you can see that I have elements or numbers like a11, a12, a13, a21, a22 and so on. Now these horizontal lines which you are seeing is called rows. So 1, 2, 3, like that, how many rows I have? I have m rows, and this vertical lines, they are called columns. So 1, 2, 3, etc. are the columns. So this is how we represent a m by n matrix. In compact form, this matrix is represented as A equal to Aij. Now, you see this bracket. You have to use this bracket only. The element Aij belong to ith row and jth column. So, you can see in this diagram, this is A32. So, this is in which row? This is first, second and third. So, this is in third row, and if we see column wise, this is present in the second column. So this A32 is an element which is present in third row and second column. So the element belonging Aij belongs to ith row and jth column and is called I, jth element of the matrix A equal to Aij. The element Aij, first subscript I always denotes the number of row, and the second subscript j, it denotes the number of column. So suppose this A31, if I take, then what this 3 indicates? It indicates third row, and this 1 indicates first column. Similarly, if I see this A33, so it indicates third row and third column. Now A22, you can tell which row it indicates. So it indicates second row and which column? So the column is also second column. Now let us see one example to understand how we can construct a matrix when it is given in the compact form. So here the problem is, I have to construct a 2 by 2 matrix A equal to Aij whose elements are given by Aij equal to I plus 2j whole power 2 divided by 2. Now this Ij, they are what? I is number of row and j is number of column, and our order of matrix is 2 by 2. Order of matrix, order always indicates number of rows into number of column. So first number is always indicate row and second indicates column. So this matrix A, it consists of 2 rows and 2 columns, that means total 4 elements. So let us see how we start the solution. So here you can see that Aij is given by the formula I plus 2j the whole power 2 divided by 2, where the value of I is 1 and 2 because I have two rows and the value of j is also 1 and 2. So one by one I will find all the four elements. First a11, so this a11 you can see here the number of row is 1 and the number of column is also 1, that is value of I is 1 and value of j is 1. So I put the value of I and value of j in this formula, aij equal to I plus 2j the whole square divided by 2. So once you put, you will get 1 plus 2 into 1 the whole square divided by 2, and on simplification it gives you the value 9 by 2. Similarly we can find a12. So here I replace I with 1 and j with 2, a21 like that, and finally a22. So all the four elements which I need I have find out. Now I can say that a equal to a11, a12, a21 and a22, which is equal to these elements. Now see how we are writing, like a11, then in row I am writing a12 because this first number is indicating row number. So whenever I am in the first row, whatever elements I have, the first number is going to be 1. Similarly in second row this first number is 2. This column number, if I am in one column, you can see that this column position, which is j, is same. So simple. Okay, now equality of matrices. If two matrices are given, then how we can say that these two matrices are equal? So two matrices A, where A is Aij m into n, and matrix B is Bij r into s, they are equal when m is equal to r. That means number of rows in the first matrix should be equal to number of rows in the second matrix, and n should be equal to s. That means number of column in the first matrix should be equal to number of column in second matrix, and thirdly aij should be equal to bij. So what it indicates? It indicates that a11 should be equal to b11, a12 should be equal to b12, a31 suppose should be equal to b31. So like that, if these conditions are satisfied, then I will say that matrix A and matrix B are equal. Okay, so let us see one problem based on this equality of matrix. We have to find the value of x, y, z and w such that this matrix is equal to this matrix, right? Now these two matrix are equal as equality sign we have used in between. So as these two matrix are equal, how we proceed, let us see. So first, whatever is given, so we know that the corresponding elements of two equal matrices are equal, therefore I write what is given. Then I equate this x minus y with 5 because they are equal, so their corresponding elements will also be equal. This will be equal to 3, this element will be equal to 12, and this 2x plus w will be equal to 15. So we frame four equations and I have four unknowns, so we can solve it. So x minus y is equal to 5 and 2x minus y is 12. So what we can do, we can subtract equation 1 from equation 2 and get the value of x as 7. Then we put this value of x 7 in any of these two equations. So I put it in equation 1 and get the value of y as 2. Now I got the value of x and y. So what I will do, I will use the value of x in this fourth equation, okay, and get the value of w, which is 1. And finally I put the value of w in this third equation and get the value of z. So the value of x is 7, value of y is 2, value of z is 1, and value of w is 1, right? Okay, So now let us move to understand different types of matrices. First is row matrix. Now a matrix having only one row is called a row matrix. Example, we have given A equal to 1, 2, 3. You can see that here I have only one row, number of columns are 3. So this is a row matrix of order 1 into 3. Similarly, we have a column matrix. Here you can see that we have only one column and there are 3 rows. Now rows can be 2, 3, 4 like that. So this is a column matrix. Square matrix. A matrix is a square matrix if number of rows is equal to number of columns. Example is given 1, 2, 5, 4. This is a square matrix of order 2. Now when a matrix is a square matrix, then in that case order, we are not saying that 2 cross 2 because both are same. So we say that it is a square matrix of order 2. Fine. So row matrix, only one row. Column matrix, only one column. And square matrix, number of row is equal to number of column. The next is diagonal matrix. Now a square matrix A equal to Aij is called a diagonal matrix if all elements except the leading diagonal are 0. That is Aij is 0 for all I not equal to j. Now leading diagonal, so this is a square matrix. In square we know that there are two diagonals, one is this and one is this. In matrices, this diagonal is called leading diagonal and you will find that all the elements which are not on this leading diagonal, they are all 0. So you can see that here we have all the elements 0, here also we have all the elements 0. We are not saying that key element on the diagonal should be not non-zero elements, right? That means if in place of 5 we have 0, then also this will be a diagonal element, because the definition of diagonal element is that the element on except on the diagonal element should all be 0. Clear? Scalar matrix. So a scalar matrix, a diagonal matrix in which all the leading diagonal element are same, are called the scalar matrix. You can see example, all the diagonal element are same, 5, 5, 5. So this is a scalar matrix. Now unit matrix. Unit matrix or identity matrix. Here you can see that this leading diagonal element are all 1. So diagonal matrix, scalar matrix, unit matrix or identity matrix, in all you will see that non-diagonal elements are 0. In scalar matrix, all the diagonal elements are same. In unit matrix, all the diagonal elements are 1. Thus a scalar identity matrix and matrix, this scalar identity, scalar matrix and identity matrix, they are the special types of diagonal matrix. Null matrix. A matrix whose all elements are 0 are called null matrix or the 0 matrix. So this null matrix, you can see each and every element is 0. Now upper triangular matrix. A square matrix A equal to Aij is called a upper triangular matrix if Aij is 0 for all I greater than j. For all I greater than j means number of row when it is more than number of column, then the value of element is 0. In simple way, what I can say that if you see this leading diagonal, then all the element below the leading diagonal is 0, then it is a upper triangular matrix. Lower triangular matrix. A square matrix is called lower triangular matrix if Aij is 0 for all I less than j. Now here also And the similar way, we can see that all the element above the leading diagonal, they are all zero. Now, symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. So let us first discuss the symmetric matrix. A square matrix A equal to Aij is called symmetric matrix if Aij equal to Aji for all I equal to j. That means A12 is equal to A21, A31 equal to A31. You can see in this example, okay, A12 and A21, if you see, they are -1, -1 both. A13, which is this element, and A31, this element, now they are also same. Similarly, A23, which is this 5, and A32, this is 5, they are same. Now, A11, A22 and A33, if you interchange I with J, there will be no difference. Therefore, these elements can be anything. We have to check only these elements like 12, 21, 13, 31, 23, 32, like that. If you find these elements same, then you will say that it is a symmetric matrix. Okay, now skew symmetric matrix. So in symmetric matrix, if you go again, you will find that A transpose is equal to A, or A equal to A transpose. Now what is this transpose of a matrix? We will see little ahead, so don't worry. Now skew symmetric matrix, here you will find that Aij equal to minus Aji, right? You can see in this example also, Aij, that is A12, is equal to minus of A21, A13 is equal to minus of A31, and A23 is equal to minus of A32. Okay, so Aij is equal to minus Aji. Then you will call the matrix of matrix as skew symmetric matrix. So in case of skew symmetric matrix, A transpose is equal to minus of A. For skew symmetric matrix, all diagonal element you will find as 0. Now transpose of a matrix, let A equal to Aij be an m into n matrix, then the transpose of A denoted by A transpose or A dash, this is called as A transpose, is an n into m matrix. That means what we are doing, we are interchanging row with column, such that A transpose ij is equal to Aji. Alright, by definition you will find it little difficult. Now see, with this example, I have a matrix A, okay, then if I have to find a transpose, then what we are doing, we are interchanging this row with column, we are interchanging this second row with this second column, simple. So this is how we find the transpose of a matrix. Now there are some properties. Okay, for any matrix A, if I find a transpose and then I transpose it, then I will get the original matrix. If I have two matrix A and B of the same order, then A plus B, the whole transpose is the same as A transpose plus B transpose. The third property is that if for any matrix A, I find K into A, that is I multiply the matrix A with some scalar and find its transpose, so it will be same as K into A transpose. And finally, if there are two matrix A and B, okay, where the product A and B is defined, then in that case A into B, the whole transpose, will be equals to B transpose into A transpose. So these are four properties of transpose of matrix. So here we end up with our first lecture. What we done here? So here we have seen definition of matrix and various types of matrix. In the next lecture, we will see some what we can say that some multiplications or some operations on the matrix. So in next lecture, we will see different operations on the matrix. Thank you.